In the last 30 to 40 years, we've lost 90% of the corals in the Caribbean and about 50% across the Indo-Pacific. Where we are, we have good information that the major problem is overfishing.
The fieldwork for this study was conducted in Fiji on their main island on the coral coast.
It's around a little town called Coralevu, and we actually live in a little village called Vatua. And so we've been made part of the village. We kind of have to operate by village standards. We get to live on the edge of it and are kind of the only non-Fijians living in the village. In our areas, if you're in the marine protected area, there's sort of 40 to 50% live coral cover. So half the bottom is live coral when you look down, and there's virtually no seaweeds. There's anywhere from 0 to 2% seaweeds. When you go outside of the marine protected area, and generally as you're swimming over, it's good, and then there's a hedge of seaweed that sort of comes up. And so instead of 40, 50, 60% coral cover, we have 4 to maybe 16% coral cover. And instead of 0 to 2% seaweeds, we have 50 to 90% seaweeds. So you've just traded seaweeds for corals where you fish and where you don't.
I collected fish from both the protected and the non-protected sites, and I was able to find 15 species that were from both areas. And we collected those fish, and then I ran them in a choice chamber, and that basically lets me ask the fish, which water do you want to be in, this water or that water?
What we show in this study is that both coral larvae and fish, when they're babies and are coming back in, they can smell the marine protected areas and go to them, and they can smell the fished areas and avoid them.
This is one of the first studies that has been able to show that coral larvae can make pretty refined decisions using chemical cues. They show very strong preferences that are identical to the fish.
We could track down that it's certain seaweeds that are making the fished area smell bad and certain corals that are making the protected area smell good.
I think the main finding of the study is that in areas where there's a very healthy reef right next to a very degraded reef, the amount of spillover from the healthy reef into the degraded site, or the amount of larval connectivity from the healthy reef into the degraded site, may be reduced just based on the chemical signatures of those two sites. You have to think of these fish and coral larvae as having this fairly highly evolved ability to detect good habitat. I mean, coral, once they settle, they don't get to move. So their initial settlement choice is really important that they make a good one. Habitat choice is so important for them, and if the habitats are so different and one just is not healthy, they're probably not going to go there, and our data confirms that.